trickle in, and then we will be on our way with the show.
I would like to welcome you to Junior High Come Alive. My name is Melissa Colve, and I'm the theater director for both junior high and senior high here at BCHS. I just want to give you a little bit of a background here on our show tonight. You know, everything was hard this year. We all know that, and I think we're all sick of saying it. But it's just nice to see so many people here and just feel normal again. But when I was thinking about our plays this summer and, you know, taking a theater frozen in time from last year, I was wondering what we would be able to do. And this fall was really hard with senior high and with so many quarantine and all those things that come along with coaching in a pandemic. But our kids for senior high were not able to do a performance other than a matinee for siblings and those kinds of things. So that was hard on them. And so if you remember last year, if you had a seventh grader or eighth grader last year, you would remember that the junior high kids kind of had the same thing dealt to them. Little did we know that Friday the 13th, when we put on our matinee, that would be our only performance. So those of you that have a seventh grader this year, they were the only ones that actually got to see the play last year. So that's kind of a fun fact for them, but not for all of you that never got to see your kids perform. So anyway, when I was trying to mull this over, and you know, you just can't plan too many things in advance when you're working through these things, but I was trying to decide what we could do for junior high to make it easier and not so hard as it was for senior high in the fall. So I was at home, and my husband says, well, why don't you just do a whole bunch of little skits and have them go on stage? Parents just want to see them up there. Like, okay, well, how do you do that? And then it came to mind that I'm a BCHS alumni, and so back in the day, I'm not going to give you years, But we used to do what was called the Junior Live Show. And it was a fundraiser for the junior class, so it was done in the 80s and early 90s. And so I was like, well, we could kind of make it like that. So that's kind of what I went off of, and you know, I brought it to the kids and said, this is what I'm thinking, and you guys are going to be responsible to write your own skits and, you know, come up with all these things. And they thought it was fun, and I had talked to a few parents earlier, and my friend Nicole had said, you have to bring back the Boogaloo. So for those of you that are BCHS alumni, you will know that will be our last skit, and it is the Boogaloo. So that'll be fun. Anyway, I think the kids have done a super fantastic job. They've been so creative. They've written all of these skits, choreographed dances. They've just they've been fantastic, and they've done it with such willing hearts, and they're always willing to give anything I ask. They just go above and beyond, and if someone's gone, they just step right in. So this group of kids has been super fun to work with, and I'm just really proud of them. There's a couple thanks that I need to give. Those of you that won't see, you know, your kid on stage necessarily, those that are backstage and helping out backstage, I really appreciate all of our backstage crew. And those that are in the booth, they do a fantastic job too with sound and lights and those kinds of things. I'd also like to give a thank you to Kyla Fetch, who has helped us with costumes. So she organizes Granny's Closet and we get things from there, and that's awesome, and we thank Granny's Closet too for providing those. And Diane Holhalter has also helped out with a few details as well. One person I really do need to thank though is Mr. Derek Barrett. And Derek has been, honestly, I am going to say my lifeline. I am technology like bad. Like, I can't even tell you. It's ridiculous. But anything that I have asked of Derek, he has always, like, I swear he can read my mind. I'm like, this is what I'm thinking for a song. What do you think? And he comes up with something that's just more than perfect. He makes the kids sound good. He works so hard. And I'm just so thankful for him. And he is a senior. And so he's done this for many years. And so tonight is his last night in the booth. And Jane Johnson, pay special attention to Derek Barrett.
First game of baseball at the high school, but guess what? It didn't happen.
Meanwhile, while I can't finish reading our pages, Taylor Swift has written, sang, and produced 2 albums. I'm sure we all know who our superintendent, Mr. Johnson, is, but did you also know he is frequently called Mr. Banner? Well, he is, and it's because he wants a banner made for everything. from swimming to what's on lunch on Wednesday. There's a banner. Our opening skit pays tribute to the love of banners here in Valley City. Introducing more banners. On your permanent seating chart.
Why does Nancy have a red check?
Because she keeps calling mine Majestic Elk a shopping cart. It's not a shopping cart. Perhaps there's some way to solve this. Perhaps a deep with thought. Oh, God. Of course. I was thinking to myself,
self.
If con is the opposite of pro, what's the opposite of progress?
I get it.
Now, let's see if it works. Majestic Oak.
Shopping cart.
What is the wrong now? Nancy keeps calling my Majestic Oak a shopping cart. It's not a shopping cart. Right. I know how to fix that problem. I think what we need is more banners. Majestic Elf, clearly a shop. Clearly not a shopping cart.
seriously?
Come on, Jimmy.
What's the issue?
Jimmy said he was catching my drift. Jimmy said he was ready to giddy up and go. Did he do either of those things? No.
That's it. I'm going to go look for Jimmy.
Mrs. Clore, wait.
Well, now what are we going to do? She left.
We wait for Mrs. Clore to bring Jimmy back.
What are we doing to get Jimmy?
We give him.
No, don't say it.
We give him. It can't be. We give him.
Whatever we're giving Jimmy, I'm intrigued.
Anyway, we get an ER, educational recovery.
No, there has to be another way.
Yay, ER. Hey, Jimmy, I'll give you one last chance. Finish this GRA on a separate piece of paper. You catching my drift?
No.
Oh, God.
The students aren't catching your drift, Mr. Bjorn? Then I guess we need more banners.
Wait, what?
Musical. Oh yeah, and don't clap for Linda May.
extra hockey game last night?
Yeah, I bet good money on the Jets, eh?
Guess what?
They won.
Well, what are you doing, Johnny?
Oh, me? Just forget about it.
Well, sit down.
So anyway, the associate we've been talking to forgot to make his payment, so we sent him on a trip to the ice fishing hall.
What a new pair of concrete Jordans, if you know what I mean.
And by that you mean you're gonna kill him, right?
Let's just say I'll be swimming there for a while.
We all know that by that you mean you're gonna kill him.
What are you doing, Johnny?
You know, sometimes I just think we go a little heavy on the metaphors, that's all.
Sit down!
Bad, this is bad.
What is it?
Well, it's going to jail for lunch, right? You know, underground hockey, gambling, and,
Yeah, and how's that going, by the way? You know, the hand gestures aren't really helping me. Can you just verbally acknowledge your wrongdoings? Hey, I have an idea. Let's go around the room, state our full legal names, and all the bad things we've ever done. Sound fun?
You know, boys, I'm starting to feel something.
Yeah, well, that's why I'm here. More word on the street has more of your guys as a rat.
Well, boys, I think we know who the rat is.
Oh, guys, I'm no rat. I'd never do something like this.
Freeze, dirtbag!
Put your hands where we can see them.
About time you guys showed up.
Wait, Jimmy, you're the rat?
Yes, I'm also part of CSIS, meaning FBI. It's my job to get in the gangs like this and shut them down.
But we all thought it was Johnny.
Yeah. Johnny is just a freak with no personal space.
See, guys, I told you it wasn't me.
Before, I used to go into jail for a long time. Oh, and the jail's been really overcrowded lately, so the four used to be sharing a cell.
Hey, that's great. Now we can go over our thoughts and feelings in great detail.
Run for it!
Hi, I'm Billy.
And I'm...
a cheese curd.
Your name is Silly.
And I'm Silly.
Where's my sock?
Look it up. Anyway, welcome to
Silly and Billy's amazing, extravagant, super really, 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 really awesome
comedy show.
We agreed it would be called the Billy and Silly Comedy Show. Not whatever that was.
Whatever. Are you ready to laugh here?
Stop. Hammer time! Yeah, that's what I was gonna say.
You know, there's kids in the audience, right?
Yeah, see, hammer time. Anyway, let's get started.
Okay.
Did you hear about the actor who fell through the floorboards?
Nope.
He was just going through his stage.
Oh, I get it. Going through a stage. And also going through stage, like, mentally. That makes sense.
What does a nosy pepper do?
I don't know.
What?
Gets all up in your business.
Oh, I get it. Jalapeno like the pepper and all of your business! These are really good jokes.
What do you call a parade of rabbits popping backwards?
I don't know. What?
A receding hairline.
Oh, I get it. Hair is another name for a rabbit, and a receding hairline goes backwards. Speaking of rabbits, look at this super adorable rabbit I found on the side of the road. I named him Alfred.
That's not a rabbit, that's a rat.
You are criticizing Alfred.
It's a rabbit. Why did the chicken cross the road?
I don't know why.
To, get to the other side.
Just laugh already. First Alfred, now chicken!
And that's our show.
Thank you.
But since there's not a general theme to the play this year, there are no snacks. No, I'm just kidding. I'm hilarious. It's because of COVID. But, thankfully, Trevor and I here are going to enjoy snacks for you.
You know, speaking of food, our school has many great choices for lunch, ranging from chicken sandwich to chicken breast to chicken nuggets to chicken strips.
Boiled chicken, broiled chicken, chicken salads, and
frozen peas. Have you ever been to Valley City and wondered, what are some good places to eat or to go, or where's the new hot spots? Well, here's Stefani to inform you on all of the new and hot spots in Valley City.
Town's correspondent Stefani has all the details on Valley City's hottest spots. Hi, Stefani!
Hello. Valley City's hottest pizza place is Pizza Corner, and it has everything. A place that probably hasn't been cleaned since 2003. Super sticky drink fountains. A room that you're only allowed into if it's a birthday party that you're invited to. A smell that never leaves the cavernings of your nose. Or clothes. And a smiling potato on every pizza box.
I'm sorry. What smiling potato are you talking about?
You know, the potato with the hat.
Wait. Do you mean this?
Yes, that! A smiling potato that wears a hat.
Stefani, that's a piece of date.
I always thought it was a potato.
Never mind. So, tell me, Stefani, if someone, maybe a family, is looking for some entertainment, where could they go if they want to have some enjoyment?
If you or your family are looking for entertainment in Valley City, look no further. Valley City's hottest and only movie theater is the Twin Cinemas, and it has everything. Broken armrests that fall off a metal armature every time you put your arm on them. The stickiest floors your shoes will ever walk on in your life. A very noticeable hole in the screen. You will be enjoying the movie until you notice it, and you'll just be staring at that hole. The latest movies from 2016, anything from Disney's Zootopia to the remake of Ghostbusters with the female leads, the movie which everyone liked.
I'm noticing some sarcasm in your voice when you say that. Let's move on before anyone starts protesting.
Quite sarcasm.
Moving on.
Okay.
Now tell me, Stefan, if a family was looking to do some sightseeing,
where in Valley City would they go? If you're looking for sightseeing in Valley City, look no further. Valley City's hottest bridge. Valley City's hottest bridges are...
Something wrong, Stefani?
No, nothing's wrong. I'm just wondering if I want to go through with all the mental pain and suffering of listing all these bridges.
Come on, Stefani, the people are waiting.
Oh, all right. Start your tour north of town at the grandest, longest, highest railroad bridge in the whole universe. Don't look that up. Named after a French Hawaiian explorer, Jacques Helany. The Helany. As you're coming back into town, don't forget to stop at the city parking lot to check out the city parking lot footprints. Heading southeast, take a gander at the mill to... Are there miners here? The Mildang Bridge. Heading directly west, make your way along the glorious BCSU Walking Phoenix Bridge. Not named after the Joker himself. Never forget to stop at a majestic site. Located by the creepy tourist campsite, named after the rarest, most beautiful bell constructors out there, we have the Rainbow Constrictor Bridge. Don't be fooled by its beautiful hues of, well, of white. It's not a real snake. And finally, you must stop at this magical bridge. It makes you feel alive, if you're not already feeling alive. We have the most spectacular, awe-inspiring, creative bridge out there. If you thought these past bridge names were creative, you clearly haven't heard the name of this gorgeous bridge. The last amazing bridge we have that is a must-see. And for those of you over 60, it may be the last bridge you ever see. The hospital bridge. Showers to get that. A pretty exciting rodeo. Sometimes there's a show where people on horses like shoot balloons with a gun, and other people have to run out and replace the balloons before another person on a horse comes out. And... I did it once. I never want to do it again. Didn't scar, I'm not gonna lie to you.
Oh, I'm sorry, I guess.
Thanks, Beth. Anyway, back to the winter show. The winter show also has spectacular cinnamon sugar mini donuts with just a hint of hay. A bunch of little kooky stores, anything from bedazzled jeans to little marionette puppets. I don't care. And if you go to the winter show, you can never forget to stop at the most popular place. The cotton candy trailer thing that sells cotton candy, maybe hot dogs, and I don't really know what the store's called. Do you have any idea of it?
I don't know, maybe the concession stand.
Yes! That's a good word to describe it. Never forget to stop at the concession stand, because that's where they sell the best cotton candy for miles around. Flavors as eccentric as blue, and taste so marvelous as pink. You have a wide variety of flavors.
Would you like to tell the people what these flavors are?
No.
The funny, the correct answer is yes.
Oh, there's a correct answer. Sorry, yes, I'll let the people know.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. You will get a wide variety of flavors of this magnificent cotton candy. You could choose from blue, purple, pink, green, and possibly yellow. And don't forget, all of these flavors have a little extra something to make your experience enjoying this sweet little cloud of diabetes even better. With hints of manure and diesel fuel.
Isn't that wonderful?
But wait, I heard they're adding a new flavor of cotton candy to the menu this year.
Let me guess. Orange.
Beth? That's a color.
Well, what's the new flavor, Stefani?
The new flavor being added to the menu is... Hey!
Hi? Tell us the new flavor, we're waiting.
I told you, the new flavor is hey.
Oh, the new flavor is hey.
What? I didn't say anything. Oh, right. Anyway, the new cotton candy flavor is hey, and it's wonderful. It gets you into the real rodeo spirit, and there's not a flavor quite like it.
Well, thank you, Stefani. I think you've really helped us out.
I know. It's what I do.
And that's all we have for tonight. I'd like to give a big thanks to Stefani, our own town correspondent, for giving us all the details on Valley City's hottest spots. Thanks for watching. I'm Beth Myers.
And I'm Stefani.
Reminding you to have a great night, Valley City.
Now, can we have some smiling potato pizza?
It's pizza day!
sure, and I hope, that we all know who the Disney princesses are. I'm sure we all have our favorite one, too. But imagine if they all got together for a sleepover. The fun, the giggles, and the drama.
All of it?
It was their holiday.
I brought pizza.
Yay, pizza!
You are so amazing, Prince Charming.
I know.
And some.
I am well aware of that.
And your eyes are just so...
Blue?
I was gonna say empty, but I guess it's possible.
In a parallel universe.
Why are you so, what's the word?
Salty.
Yeah, salty. You've been acting like this since the prince showed up.
It's probably because she lives in the ocean.
No!
No, it's because he's a... A monstrosity.
He bought us pizza, Ariel. Pizza. Do you need me to spell it out for you? P-I-Z.
I know how to spell pizza.
So what's your point? Why is he a monstrosity?
Well, look at him. He's ugly and he's wearing leather pants that are way too small.
I don't see anything wrong with what he's wearing.
How are the floors coming along?
Oh, he got you good.
And Belle, how's the dog?
I don't have a dog.
Oh, sorry. How's your husband? Oh, Snow, look what I brought for you. Look how ripe it is. And Jasmine.
If you say anything rude about me or my family, you're going straight into the Cave of Wonders.
You go, Jasmine.
Oh, Tiana, don't you think you should hippity hop out of here?
That was a curse. I am not a frog. You can see me here right now, right here. I'm all flesh and bone.
Oh, ew.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your extensions.
They are not extensions!
You're right, he's no Prince Charming.
Yeah.
Well, I never said it was Prince Charming.
Yes you did.
Okay, when?
I heard Wait, yeah. He never did say anything about him being Prince Charming. You are Prince Charming, right?
Well, I am, but I'm also not.
And what do you mean by that?
I'm actually...
Actually?
The name's Prince Barney Charming. Prince Barney Charming of the Hidden Western Eastern Islands.
But West East isn't a direction.
Exactly. That's why they're hidden.
That explains a lot.
Now that we got that cleared up, can we start having some real fun?
Pillow fight! Woo!
Thank you. Two, three, four. What did you say?
Well, according to my book, that is some cow poo.
1, 2, 3, 4,
Jaden hit it.